Welcome everyone to my channel that is Fast and Easy Maths, which is dedicated to give you tips and tricks related to mathematics. So students, today we are going to understand very basic of algebra, okay? Lot of students have obviously understood this, but I get a lot of requests on making these kind of videos. So I thought that first, let me just make this about addition and subtraction. And if you want, I will put another video for multiplication and division. If you want, so please put a yes in the comment section so that I know that is something which you are interested in having. Okay. So now the question over here, or rather what we are having, I have taken few very simple understanding. One second. I was saying, well, I've taken very few basic, not even sums actually, basic examples for you all to get a hang of it. So now here, if you see x plus 3, please understand, if your x is as it is, if you do not have any variable with x, we are going to take it as nothing but 1. Okay, 1x plus 3. Now, if 3 also does not have anything related to x, we are going to keep it as it is. Please understand, if the question was 1x plus 3x, we would have added 1 and 3. But since here, this one is a constant. See, any number without a variable will be taken as constant, okay? So you cannot add 1 and 3. Now here we have x plus x. Like I said, if you just have a single x, we are going to take it as 1x. So 1x plus 1x is going to get you 2x. Now 3x minus 2x. So here, when you're subtracting, you're just going to follow all the rules what you have learned till now. So 3 minus 2 is going to get you 1. So 1x, or we can write just x, okay? Now 2 minus x will get you what again? Just x, okay? Now we have 5x minus 6x. Please understand, when we have 5 and 5 minus 6, what we get answer is negative, minus 1. So we get minus 1x, or we are going to write it as just minus x. So I hope you got this. It is super simple. If you've understood this, you will be able to solve all of these very easily. Not at least, if not these two, you will be able to solve the rest. Okay, if you want, you can take a pause and try solving them, and you can see whether your answers are matching with whatever I have explained. Okay, also students, if you like the way I'm explaining, then please go ahead and hit the like button, because that gives me tremendous amount of encouragement in doing these kind of videos. Okay, so now we have 5 plus 3x plus 2x. Now 5 does not have any variable with it, so we'll write 5 as it is. Now 3 plus 2 is getting you 5. So we are getting right this as nothing but 5 plus 5x. Now understand, when you have the same coefficient, so coefficients are basically number 5 is common to both the terms. So we have 5, we can take 5 outside. So we'll write this as 1 plus x. We can also do this if you want. See, later on when you're doing complicated sums, something like this will really help, because there will be things in your denominator which might get cancelled. Okay. So just for practice, you start with this only, right? Write down your answers in whatever things you get as common. Okay. So now here we have 7 plus minus x plus 2 plus 3x. Now understand, when you have something like this, all you have to do is, we are just going to talk about the constants as of now. Constants means the numbers which do not have the variable. So those numbers are 7 and 2. We are going to, and the signs with this, both of them is plus. So we are going to add both of them. So answer is going to be 9. Now we have 3x minus x. So basically 3 minus 1. Why 1? Because the coefficient with x over here is just 1. So 3 minus 1 is going to get you 2, and your x will come ahead with it, okay? Now understand, please always make sure that you are talking about the, or you are doing your addition subtraction operations with the coefficients of your variable and the constants separately. You cannot add these two like I mentioned over here. Okay, so now coming to the next one, we have 2x minus 5xy plus 7. Now here, I'm sure you must be wondering that, okay, chalo, yahan pe bhi we can add and subtract. No, you can't do that. You cannot absolutely do that, because the variables are different. Here the variable is xy, here the variable is y, and here you have an x. So when you have like, you know, three or other any elements with different variables, you cannot directly add and subtract. You're going to keep it as it is. Here, if they were giving you plus 2, then you would have done plus 2y, then you could have added 7y and 2y, okay? But nothing more than that. So basically, your addition subtraction operations happen only with the variables which are same. The ones, the terms which do not have the same variable, we will keep it as it is. So here your answer will remain 2x minus 5xy plus 7y. Okay. Yes, you can split minus 5xy and you get your answers. Yeah, that happens. But that's a that's, I think, something which I'll leave it for the next video. Okay. Because this is something which I'm just making you all understand what to do with algebra basics. Okay. So now over here we have what? 10xy minus 7x plus 7y. Minus 3xy. Again, we have only two terms with same variables. Okay. So basically these terms which have got the same variable are taken as what? Like terms. So you can do your operations of addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. No, not multiplication, division. Only addition and subtraction when it comes to like terms. So 10xy minus 3xy. 10 minus 3 is going to get you 7xy. Now minus 7x, do you have any other term with an x? No. Just an x we don't have. So minus 7x. Plus 7y, again, we do not have any term with y. So, we are going to take 7 out and we are going to leave it as it is. Again, I'm reminding all of y'all that you can leave your answers here. That is absolutely okay. But this is a practice which I want all of y'all to follow. Because when it comes to complicated sums, it is necessary to understand what to be taken out and what can be taken inside your bracket. Okay. So the next one we have minus 3x plus 8x square. Please understand, we have a term which has got a x square. Okay, now there is another term which has 8x plus 2. So now which terms are called like minus 3x plus 8x? So we can do the subtraction. Minus 3 plus 8 will get you 5x plus 8x square will be written as it is. And plus 2 will also be written as it is because we do not have any other constant. Okay. Sorry, I've got a bad throat today. 5x cube plus 2x square minus 3x plus 8x square minus 2x cube plus 1. So when you have something like this, let's talk about the like terms. Okay. Now, one very common practice which I always teach my students is that cancel out the operations which you have already done. So 5x cube minus 2x cube. These are the two terms which are common. 5 minus 2 is going to get you 3x cube. So I'm going to cancel these two. Now 2x square plus 10x square. Plus 8x square. 2 plus 8 is going to get you 10x square. So I'm going to cancel these two as well. Now minus 3x. If you have any other term with x, then we can do the operation. But here we do not have. So we'll write it as it is. And then we're just going to put a plus 1. Okay, so now you saw how simple this becomes when you are doing or when you have understood this basics of algebra when it comes to addition and subtraction. Okay, so now time for your DIY. Do let me know what is your answer for 10xy plus 3x minus y plus 2y plus 4x. Okay, do let me know your answers in the comment section. So that's it for today. I will very soon see you in the next video.